I'm Mark Saxton.
I'm Joey Cundiff.
This is Blue Collar Sports Talk. Let's talk some shit. Let's do it. It's been a decent weekend for sports, huh?
No, terrible weekend. Absolutely horrendous.
All right, well, to a good show. Yeah. This episode's brought to you by FHC Family Insurance. Let Chris know, the good old boys from Blue Collar Sports Talk sent you. Get a quote. For home, auto, and life insurance, 928-524-3754 or 3760. So, that being said,
we're going to skip right over the pick'ems, right?
I am winning, but not only am I winning.
Yeah.
I am winning big. Why don't you read those scores back to me?
So, now, there might be a recount.
Okay. Dominion must have counted them.
Yeah. We need a recount because I think these are wrong. I have 65 points.
You hear the big one.
You're at 73. Now, I wanted to stop at 65 because that sounds like a lot. But, you know, we're coming back. We had an almost perfect week by you.
I did. I missed just two.
Two games. Only one that cost you a point.
Carolina and Seattle.
Yeah. Carolina ruined me on my parlay. I hit my whole parlay except for Carolina.
That whole team ruined my entire day.
They sure did.
They were the majority of the game was 5-3.
Yeah. I thought I was watching baseball.
Yeah, it was awful.
Even then, boring.
Yeah.
5-3.
Yeah.
I want those 11-0 games. Come on.
That being said, let's move right on to the rush hour. Goodness. Why don't I start us off?
Go ahead.
With my boys, the pack doing what the pack do. 24-10 victory over Washington. Some slow areas for us, but for one, this is the first time in like 30 games total that we were actually able to stop someone in the red zone. Positives plus.
Too bad it was the fierce competitors of the Washington football team.
I'll take it where I can get it. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Washington, let's start with the Washington side. Heinicke, not a terrible day. 25-37, 268 yards, and a TD and an INT. Could have been better. Could have been worse. He also rushed for 95 yards with 10 carries. There was a couple of times where I thought he was going to go.
He
a leading rusher for the day.
Yeah.
Scary Terry doing it. 7 receptions, 122 yards, and a TD. Well, Rodgers doing Rodgers things. 27-35, 274 yards, 3 tutties. Jones, I mean, our running game really wasn't.
It was not there.
Yeah, it wasn't there. I mean, he had 6 carries, 19 yards. Devontae, 6 receptions, 76 yards, and a TD. So,
Devontae closing in on 1,000 yards almost already.
Yep.
You know?
He's doing work this year. Doing work this year. I mean, what can you say? 76 yards compared to, you know, that's a bad day
That is a bad day for
compared
Devontae.
To the rest of his days. Why don't you take me to Tennessee? What happened?
Something was wrong with the broadcasting. I think Patrick Mahomes is officially colorblind.
Yeah.
And just, I blame it on Jackson Mahomes filming TikToks. That's got to be very distracting when you're trying to be a quarterback, you know? Well, Kansas City lost 3-27, just like I predicted. Patrick Mahomes on 20-35, 206 yards, and a interception. He's tied with your boy Zach Wilson in interceptions. He has 9 of them things.
A lot of turnovers. A lot of turnovers.
He was also their leading rusher with 35 yards. You know, I picked Patrick Mahomes in my DraftKings fantasy team.
I thought
he was going to go off. I thought he was going to be angry. Then Pringle had 5 receptions for 73 yards. I also picked him up in my fantasy league. So, needless to say, I donated Vegas $3.
Yeah, there you go.
Ryan Tannehill went 21-27, 270 yards, a touchdown, and an interception. It's a very Ryan Tannehill game.
Yeah.
Just game manager. Derrick Henry, 29 carries, 86 yards. No big game from Derrick Henry. A.J. Brown went 8 receptions, 133 yards, and a touchdown.
Have a day, huh?
He had a day.
Have a day.
You know, this one's just a little sad because this one I thought for sure Kansas City was going to come back, but
Tennessee was flying high on you know, their previous game, and I knew they were going to win.
Yeah. You knew it. Yeah, I can't even see. I can't argue right now. It hurts my soul.
I'll take you to Miami.
Go ahead.
Move on a little bit.
Leave me in Miami.
Well, this is something else I was right on.
Yeah, yeah, it is.
Atlanta over Miami, 30-28.
Yep.
Matty Ice playing Matty Nice.
Yeah.
25-40, 336 yards, 2 TDs. He did have a mistake in there. Ended up not mattering. Cordell Patterson, 14 carries, 60 yards and a tutty.
Yep.
Pitt, 7 receptions, 163 yards. How do you have that day and not find the end zone?
Yeah. And he had a very nice one-handed catch, too.
Yeah, absolutely. Tua.
Turn the ball over.
32 32-40. 291 yards. 4 TDs. But as you just said, he had some issues on the interceptions. Yeah. Two of them things.
Yeah.
Gaskin, who cares? 15 carries, 67 yards.
There's a lot of that this week. Jacobs, who cares? That's
right. Gesicki, 7 receptions, 85 yards, and a tutty.
Tight ends leading the day, leading the way. I mean,
ultimately, Atlanta getting the winning field goal when it counted. They also covered the spread for me. Thank you.
Yeah. I did pick them to cover the spread, though. Erica, to win that one in my parlay. I was thinking about it. I was like, you know, I'm going to go that route.
They did.
And it worked.
It did work.
But, yeah, so I'm going to take us to Boston. Hey. What'd you say about that?
Hey.
I was right on this one. Finally.
Giving them the Boston Bean Kid.
They sure showed him. They hurt him. I didn't mean to say hurt him. They beat him so bad that Zach Wilson decided he didn't want to play football for a few weeks. That's what happened.
I don't think he had much of a choice.
Yeah, so even without Tom Brady, the Patriots are still stomping on the Jets. It was 13-54. Bill Belichick could have ran the ball out, but he put in Brian Hoyer and said, throw the ball, let's get more touchdowns. You know, you can't blame him. Mac Jones went 24-36, 307 yards and 2 touchdowns. Harris had 14 carries, 106 yards and 2 touchdowns. And Bolden,
out of nowhere.
Out of nowhere. 6 receptions, 79 yards and a touchdown. Mr. White over here on the, and that's his last name as well. Backup quarterback for the Jets. So he went 20 of 32, 202 yards, a touchdown, and a pick. Carter, who cares? 11 carries, 37 yards.
Not a big day.
You know, you're in the NFL. Good job.
Just shy of a big day.
Just shy. Now, he did have 8 receptions and 67 yards. So let me take that who cares into, you know what? All the right. He had a day. He showed up. Yeah, but who is this guy? Mike White. Okay. Showing that he, you know, he could be better than Cam, I guess. You know?
Well.
Cam's out
there. Something like that.
Go ahead and take me to the most...
stupidest game.
No, because that was Monday night. Yes, take me to the second stupidest game.
So, once again, the majority of the game was 5-3.
Yeah.
Darnold, hey, you know what? We said, hey, we found you a home.
Yeah.
You're doing good. The Panthers are the real deal. I take back everything.
Yeah, the Broncos are better than the Panthers. I'm saying it now. The entire
organization is suspect.
Yes.
Every single one of you. All right, Darnold, who I believe wasn't the only quarterback to play that
game. He was not.
16 for 25, 111 yards, and an INT. And that's, I mean, you know, that speaks for itself there. Okay. Hubbard,
who cares?
28 yards on 12 carries. Almost 2.5 yards a carry.
Yeah, yeah.
More. Well, I mean, DJ Moore.
We need more.
We need a lot more.
Well, yeah.
6 receptions, 73 yards.
He had over half of the yards from Sam Darnold.
Who cares? Yeah. Danny Dimes.
Did you see that Odell Beckham Jr. catch Danny Dimes had?
Yeah.
Oh, my gosh. That was
phenomenal. Danny Dimes, 23 of 33, 203 yards, and a tutty. Mm-hmm. No mistakes.
No.
No mistakes. Maybe he's finally not concussed.
less concussed.
Booker ran for 51 yards on 14 carries and a tutty. Slayton, 5 receptions, 63 yards. Ultimately, the game was over before a lot of these things, but...
I don't know how you lose that many starters and still find a way to win.
And they did. They did. Big.
Now, this is on me. You know what? I'm not mad that they won. I'm mad because I picked them to lose. I have Joey B's jersey, and I picked them to lose.
You betrayed
them. Not only did they prove me wrong.
Not I.
They hurt me bad. 41-17. The number one team in the AFC.
doing work.
The number one team in the AFC. Can you believe that?
Well,
they are.
There's a couple people that had a bye.
You and these buys, man, I tell you. But Joe Burrow went 23 of 38, 416, three touchdowns and a pick. That's a great day at the office. You know, and while we're speaking, you know, yeah, they have they're the number one team in the AFC. Maybe it's because of a bye, but Sam Darnold was also the best quarterback because of a bye in one time, so I just want you to know that. At one point in time in the season, Sam Darnold was the best quarterback.
So now you think Joey B's going to take a left turn here?
He's going to be the best quarterback.
Okay, all right.
You know, I'm seeing a trend.
Okay.
Joe Mixon, Mr.
Mix match,
59 yards and a touchdown. It would have been a who cares, but he did.
He crossed the goal line.
Yeah. Jamar Chase.
Doing work.
Why draft O-line when you can draft Jamar Chase?
Yeah, I agree.
I mean,
he can do it all.
Yeah. 8 receptions, 201 yards and a touchdown. I mean, he's got some
rushing yards on there, too, I believe.
Yeah. He does. Speaking of rushing yards, Lamar Jackson threw for 15 of 31. You like how he did that?
Yeah.
257 yards and one touchdown. Lamar Jackson also ran for 88 yards on 12 carries. And Hollywood Brown, 5 receptions, 80 yards, and a touchdown.
Hollywood? Didn't matter, did it?
Didn't matter. Not one bit.
Another game that I was correct on.
You know, Philly, this is what I get.
You pick Philly.
I pick Philly.
I picked the Raiders.
I don't know why. 30, I pick Philly.
33-22, Vegas. Hey, just like Tyson Fury said, walking in Vegas. let's start with the winning side. Huh? I stayed in the carpool.
Yeah,
31 of 34. 323 yards, 2 tutties. Yeah. He did have a mistake there. But, I mean, that's a day. Kenyon Drake, a day. 14 carries, 69 yards, and nice. A TD. That is a perfect day.
That's a very nice day. Got the TDs and the 69.
You know what I mean?
How much more can you ask?
Moreau, 6 receptions, 60 yards, and a tutty. Let's go to the they've got to be used to losing.
Sure.
Jalen Hurts, you're going to get his jersey soon. That's going to be cool.
Stop.
18-34, 236 yards, and 2 tutties. He also went for 61 yards on 13 carries. Mm-hmm. Goddard, 3 receptions, 70 yards. Ultimately, who cares?
You know, when am I going to get back in the carpool? I'm the one at the beginning of the season that told you to stay in there.
Yes,
now I've been hedging my bets against the carpool.
You know, we're not all perfect.
But somebody who is perfect, Matt Stafford did have an almost perfect game. Not really, actually. They won 28-19, a lot closer than what it should have been.
No, I bet on Lions, the spread. You Lions fans out there, do you miss Matt?
No.
I would.
Matt Patricia. It's Jared Goff we trust out there. You know, I bet the spread on Lions and they covered. That would have won me money, but the Panthers really suck. Matt Stafford went 28-41, 334 yards, 3 touchdowns. Henderson has had 45 yards. Who cares?
Yeah,
you know, Cooper Kupp. Oh my goodness.
Have
10 receptions, 156 yards, and 2 tutties.
Two of them dangs.
Now Jared Goff, MVP, 22-36, 268 yards. That's a lot of yards.
Right, yeah.
For Detroit. 1 touchdown and 2. I wouldn't even call them mistakes. I call them. This is what we do every week. Is it really a mistake when you keep doing it?
It's a tradition.
Right. Then the rest, who cares, you know? Raymond had 115 yards. Who cares?
Running game didn't exist. Let me take you to the best team in football versus the Arizona Cardinals.
Okay. All right, it took a turn.
No, the Cardinals won 31-5. Yeah. Who was surprised there?
Yeah.
I was shocked on the safety.
Yeah.
I was a little mad at Kyler for that. He should have seen it coming.
No, but they covered the spread, which is what I bet on.
And I made some money on that game as well. Let's start with the...
Thank you, Panthers.
I think it's going to be quicker if I start with the losing side because they didn't do too much.
There's a lot of who cares. You want to just sum it up real quick?
Mills, who cares? Johnson,
who cares?
Collins,
who cares?
Now, Kyler Murray...
Now to places we care about.
20 of 28, 261 yards, 3 tutties. He did have a mistake.
Mm-hmm.
Edmonds ran for 81 yards and 15 carries. Ertz, first... Day putting on the uni and getting him a tutty, 66 yards on 3 receptions.
Not a bad game.
Hey, They're gonna be really tested this week.
Okay. You know who tested? You know somebody who didn't want to be tested this week. Yeah. Maybe that song "Knock on Wood." Yeah. That's what the Packers should listen to.
Yeah. No, I meant the Packers were gonna be tested this week. Yeah, that's what I'm saying. So moving on.
we took another trip in Florida. This time in Florida, I was correct.
Yeah,
finally.
And hey, it's always a good day when the Bears lose.
Yes, except when Justin Fields is the reason. So Tampa Bay won 38-3. It's okay. Happens.
Shouldn't.
You know, three is a very specific number here because Justin Fields had three interceptions and three fumbles. And scored 3 points.
Okay.
He's like, he's Illuminati, trifecta. Right? Little Illuminati stuff going on, huh?
He's a, yeah.
Yeah. The rookie running back, Herbert, had 100 yards, which is cool. Cole Kmet had 43 yards receiving. Just a tight end kind of day, huh? Now to the, you know, Tom Brady. What did you expect?
Doing Tom Brady things.
20 of 30, 36, 211 yards, and 4 touchdowns. Fournette had 81 yards and a touchdown, and Godwin with 111 yards and 1 touchdown. That is a lot of ones there. A
lot of ones.
Right, it's getting late in the day. My eyes are squinting to see all those ones. not much to talk about, not much to report. Tampa Bay did Tampa Bay things, huh?
Yeah, and Chicago did Chicago things.
Yeah, you know, give Justin Fields some time.
To sit on the bench. He does not need to be out there.
No, no.
Let me tell you
something. Put the Red Rocket away.
Let me tell you something. Another game that I called right. Mm-hmm. Indy taking it to the Niners. And I am saying it now. Hit the panic button. Sound the alarm. Call the retreat. San Francisco is in trouble.
They are.
So, 30-18 final. Wentz having a Wentz day. 17 for 26, 150 yards, 2 tutties.
When is this man going to throw an interception?
I don't know. But more importantly, I mean, he did good. He did his thing because he also did a lot of rushing.
Yeah.
More importantly, when's he going to have over a 300-yard day? You know what I mean?
He's having those, like, when Jameis Winston wins kind of games, you know? You throw for 40 yards.
That's right.
And 7 touchdowns.
Taylor, 18 carries, 107 mm-hmm. yards and a tutty. Pittman, 4 receptions, 105 yards mm-hmm. and a tutty. I mean, Garoppolo, let's face it, doing Garoppolo things, 16 for 27, 181 yards, a tutty, and 2 big mistakes.
Mm-hmm.
Mitchell, 18 carries, 107 yards, and a tutty. Debo, 7 receptions, 100 yards, and a tutty. Snatching mm-hmm. chains.
And taking L's.
And taking names.
Just like, I don't know. I thought San Francisco had it. You know, California got rain, which never happens. So that's why they lost. Yeah, well, so I'm taking that pick 'em. That's a mulligan. This week was a mulligan.
You're going to need like 8 mulligans, right?
Something like that. Math is hard. And I'll take you to the worst game I've possibly ever watched ever.
That's pretty bad. No offense.
No. Jameis Winston, they won 13-10. An incredible game. 19 to 35, 222 yards and a touchdown. Kamara had 20 carries, 51 yards, but he also had 10 receptions, 128 yards and a touchdown. That is pretty
crazy.
Doing work. Geno went 12 of 22, 167 yards and a touchdown. Collins
to the 84 yard reception to DK,
opening the game up like that. I was like, oh my god, this is how we're starting. And I was like, you gotta be kidding. I'm like, I gotta win one. And then they slowed it down. He only got 1 reception after that. DK ended up with 96 yards on 2 receptions with that touchdown, of course. Oh, but man, that just that killed me.
Like I said, you folks. Be ready. We will be auctioning off that Eagles uni soon. And we haven't decided what we're going to do with that money. We wanted to give it to somebody. We wanted to be nice.
No. I'm not nice anymore.
Hopefully, we can, you know, find them Eagles fans out there.
No. I don't want you guys to watch.
All right, moving it on. All this excitement, all these new changes, all these... I would call it new behaviors.
Ooh.
Your updated top 10. Let me hear your first 3 and why.
My first 3, very simple. Cardinals, going to be 8-0. That's why. Okay. Rams doing Rams things. Now, the inconsistent play from Matt Stafford still kind of alarms me, but that defense is not going to lose very many games. And then number three, I got the old boys.
Oh, you got them boys.
I got Dallas. Trayvon Diggs did have an interception in the bye week. Dak threw for 400 yards. CD Lamb caught 200 of them. Just a normal day.
It's another day at the office.
No, it's a, you know, the most controversial one would probably be Rams and Cowboys up here.
Yeah.
I see the defense and both of them stepping up. Cowboys getting Michael Gallup back, Collins back, and old D-Law back. Yeah, three big players back. So I that's agree. Why. And they've been winning this much without him.
They haven't done anything yet. They're just coming back.
But
so
they've won
know.
This much without him.
I agree.
These
I'm
are
just
their,
saying,
some
I'm
of
just
their
saying,
top-tier saying, players.
Although, go although ahead, I... okay, so my top three. I got the Cardinals.
Uh-huh.
You know that hurt putting that there.
I know it did. That Justin, hurt. That's for you.
Wait, and here's the thing. Listen here, Justin. Your Cardinals, some of the players might be the real deal, but that coaching staff will lead you to drive off of a cliff. Believe me, you.
No.
When it comes time, and I was telling a couple of my buddies this already, when it comes time, you know, you need great people to do great things. You got Bozo running that whole ship. So it's an issue for
he's
me.
He's learning. He's learning. Every me. Day he's getting better.
It's an issue for me. Every day he's getting better. Here's the thing. My thing about the Cardinals, why I have them as number one, is their weakness is definitely the secondary, and their weakness is on the offensive side is probably that line with a couple of the injuries that they have. But the reason why I have them as a number one is because that front seven makes sure that secondary doesn't get exposed.
And Kyler.
They are running that quarterback down, and Kyler Murray is making smart choices. Mm-hmm. Actually, today I had an argument with somebody at work, said that he would take Lamar over Kyler. Okay. Well, here's the thing. Lamar might be a faster runner, but he's not a smarter runner.
Yeah.
And he doesn't make smart decisions in the air. And I think that's where Kyler beats him.
And I take Kyler's arm 10 times out of 10.
I was just going to say that. Mm-hmm. Kyler, possible MVP finalist for sure. Those are my reasons for their number one.
I bet Kyler drinks tall boys.
You know what? He might just be thugging out on the weekend. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
My number two, Bucks.
Mm.
Only because of Tom Brady. Kay. They've got a lot of injuries on the defensive side. Let's face it, who haven't been doing much. Yes, they shut down the Bears, but I mean, come on.
It's the Bears.
Yeah, everybody does.
Justin Fields shut down the Bears.
He was there. He was the Bucks' most valuable player.
Yeah, he sure was.
Basically, like I said, Tom Brady, with the weapons that he has on that offense, I think that's what makes them number two, because at the end of the day, you have to try and beat Tom Brady.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? So that's where that's at. The number three, I still have the Bills. I still have them in my top three. They had a bye week this week. I think they'll come back. That loss against the Titans, I mean, we agreed. McDermott, you made the right call.
Yeah.
I don't think that's going to hurt their confidence at all. I think they're going to bounce back and look great.
I keep reminding myself of that Steelers game. And I know it's the first game of the season, and I know it's not supposed to hold that much weight, but it kind of does. That defense just kind of got worked, and it got worked again against Tennessee, and there might be a little bit of a blueprint coming out. It might be a little early, but I still think there's some issues with that defense, that front seven.
Yeah, I don't know. Buffalo. They did bounce back from that, though. I mean, and ultimately, yes, I mean, you had Derrick Henry running all over them, but they weren't – it wasn't the game wasn't so far out of hand that the offense couldn't win.
Right.
So, I mean, you got that on their side as well.
And Stephon has been struggling a little bit this year, so that's a little bit of my concern.
Yeah, I mean, only two tutties, you know. I can see that. But, I mean, like I said, Allen's been finding another way. 4, 5, and 6, who you got?
I got the Bucks. For Tom Brady and that offense, you know, the defense is not a reason it's on there this year. I got the Bills at 5 for everything I said. You know, their offense is explosive. Their defense can get those stops, but it just makes me remember how they lost last year. Just kind of dumb plays. I'm not saying that QB sneak was a dumb play, but just leading into the game, some nowhere yards. You know, when you run it and nothing happens and you keep doing that, you're going to find yourself a loss. And then 6, I got the Packers. I still think the Packers they have the potential to beat out 5 and 4 and be, and possibly even 3. It's all dependent on how well Devontae Adams comes back. Now, you know, he is out for COVID. But just remember, there's a lot of players last year whose production dipped way down after they got COVID.
Yeah, but I mean, most of those players you're talking about had multiple COVID, where they missed multiple games.
Right, well, you know, they just came back a little sluggish, you know, and that defense on the Packers still concerns me.
Yeah.
And Mason Crosbar, too. But, I don't know, I see the Packers, they're easily able to move up and down this list. So, this 4, 5, and 6 is really, you can really change those out for me.
I got my 4 and 5 teams I can see moving up. Number 4, I have them boys.
Okay.
The only reason why they're not higher on my list right now is they haven't had the opportunity to do great things, and it's coming. I really do think so. I think they're underrated. I think that defense is underrated. I do think that defense has holes.
Mm-hmm.
That secondary is a little shaky.
Mm-hmm.
However, I mean, Diggs and Curse doing Diggs and Curse things, and I think that, you know, if the surrounding pieces pick it up as they have, you're looking at lights out.
Yeah.
Obviously, Dak, right. Zeke, CD. Mm-hmm. I mean, you name it. I could keep going on and on and on. That's a strong and tough offense, and I could take that offense against anybody in the NFL. That's just fact of the matter, especially the way Dak's playing lately.
Right.
He's on fire. My number 5 team, I have the Pack.
Mm-hmm.
Aaron Rodgers doing Aaron Rodgers things. Yep. In the last 6 games. He's 17 TDs, yep. 1 INT.
I was going to say, yeah, you're a little wrong there.
He's doing Aaron Rodgers shit for sure. The offense, obviously, the our biggest issue is the line.
Yeah.
That's been shown time and time again.
Bakhtiari's practicing now?
No, he's back.
Is he back fully?
Yeah, he's back. He's okay. Back fully. We should have him here Thursday. Well, I think it hasn't been decided, but I think they're okay. Anticipating his okay. return. But yes, he's been practicing. The rookies haven't been doing bad though. As I said, you know, the Packers team has the ability to go forward. Let's talk about that defense. A lot of holes.
Yep.
A lot more holes than the Cowboys. They are not far off from the Cowboys, but a lot more holes. Our running defense could be way better. They're not getting back there. They're not penetrating the line, getting back there and testing that quarterback an awful lot. Stokes, you know, in that secondary, is having some trouble. Yeah. We're missing Alexander. We're missing Alexander. I mean, and a couple of the other guys that are down. But would just like to point out,
mm-hmm.
in 2010,
yep.
the Packers were having this same issue.
Yep.
So I'm not going to jinx anything. I'm just saying, don't give up the faith. My number 6 spot.
He was also given the discount double check.
My number 6 spot, I do have the Rams.
Okay.
That's with the low. With yes. Honestly, I almost put them lower. But that's because the unpredictability of Matt Stafford right now.
Yeah.
That defense, it's lights out. It is. It's lights out. But you can't win if you don't score.
That's true.
So I have them at my number 6. That's my issues with them. 7, 8, and 9.
7, 8, and 9. So I made a game time decision to swap my 8 and 7.
Okay.
Coming in at number 7. Coming in hot. Joey B and the Bengals. Okay. And the Bungles. They're getting there. I don't know. They're just playing really good football. They could easily be. They almost beat the Packers in overtime. They should have. Could have. Would have.
Yeah.
But, you know, it took a rookie kicker to not. So it's okay. No, they're a really good team. They're the number one team in the AFC, like I've already said. And Joey B, if he continues to play games like this, he's definitely going to be in the MVP conversation. My number 8, who I just swapped out, is the Chargers.
Mm.
Now, I really hate to keep bringing the Chargers lower and lower, but one funny thing I saw, they're my only team on this top 10 with a negative point differential.
Mm.
Negative 2. Now, it's because of that Ravens game, but come on. Come on, Herbie. You're better than that. Yeah, but Herbie is the reason why they're at number 8 now. That defense, when it shows up, it shows up. My number 9, I'm sorry for leaving you guys out and explicitly saying you're not a top 10. Well, now not only are you top 10, you're top 9. This is the Titans. Sorry, Derrick Henry, you did your thing. Ryan Tannehill, you managed games. You're top 10. Look at you go. Yeah. So proud.
Yeah.
Thank you for proving me wrong yet again.
My 7, 8, and 9 are the exact same teams, different order.
Okay. Okay.
Number 7, I have the Chargers. Mm. Herbie, doing work. That right. defense, I don't know, man. They were a lot better than what they displayed against Baltimore. Little inconsistent, but I think that offense is more consistent. Then the Bengals.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
But not by much.
Not by much.
Not by much.
See, that's why I made my game time decision.
So I Joey B, you're almost there for me in making my top 7. But I got you down there because honestly, if it wasn't for you and about 4 other players, I don't think you'd have a team.
No, yeah.
You see what I'm saying?
Joey B or Justin Herbert? While we're on the subject,
I mean Joey B can run.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Justin Herbert's in a way better situation.
Right. Right. Equal amount of potential in their arm, I think.
Okay.
Well,
I think Herbert. No, Herbert has a stronger arm.
Does he? That's pretty close. It's pretty close. I don't know. I want to lean towards Herbert, but I have a feeling that Burrow magic mm-hmm. comes through. It's hard. It's hard not to choose him.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
I'm taking Burrow.
Yeah. Yeah, I can't blame you. But then again, I don't think you could be wrong either pick.
No, no,
you
yeah.
You know what I mean? I don't think there's a wrong answer.
No, no.
Number 9, I have the Titans. Simply beating the Rams. Mm-hmm. Or, sorry, the Bills.
When do they do that?
Beating the Bills. They have the potential to do great things. And so far, I mean, they're rising to the challenge. Yeah, they lost to the Jets. Mm-hmm. You know, that's why they're not too much higher on my list.
Yep.
But they've got room to grow for me.
They sure do.
All right. Let's say number 10 together. Ready? 1, 2, 3. Ravens.
Who cares? Oops, I mean Ravens. I hate the Ravens so much sometimes. You know, I picked the guys to win.
I think they're the pretendiest pretender at the record that they have.
They are. Maybe right there with the Raiders for me.
Yeah.
I don't know. It's so tough for me. You guys show up and do so well for so long, and then it's just like, it's just not there.
And then you get punked this weekend. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? I don't know. Like I said earlier, Lamar, you don't make the best decisions.
No.
You know, whether it's on the ground or in the air, you don't. When you do create those openings to make great plays, you don't always hit that, you know, breaking the ceiling.
And the defense is not all the way there. And these injuries are starting to show. Now, maybe I'm just overreacting because they won 3 games where I didn't think they were going to win.
Yeah, same.
So, you know, I guess time will tell. But, man, it's just so weird to have the Ravens number 10 with how inconsistent they've been. And I know they're winning close games, but they're close games.
Right.
That's my issue.
I agree. That being said, mm-hmm. those are the... Blue Collar Sports top 10 teams.
Whether you like it or not, they're top 10.
Let's talk about this Packers and Cardinals game on Thursday.
Let's do it.
I'm going to tell you right now, what you've got basically is you've got the Arizona defense mm-hmm. versus Aaron Rodgers. That's basically what this is boiling down to. I'm not going to say that the... Ideally, on paper, the floodgates aren't going to completely open.
No.
For Kyler Murray and company, but he's going to make some noise. They're going to cause some damage. Ultimately, it's going to determine how well they can hold a 2+ possession game lead on Aaron Rodgers to keep him out of the mix.
I think that's how it's going to end too.
I'm still taking Green Bay. I'm still taking Green Bay. For 2 reasons. You never bet against Rodgers.
Okay, but I am.
And the number 2 part is, at the end of the day, like I said, great organization being ran by Bozo.
Mm.
I think he'll be outcoached, even if it is by LaFleur.
Well, I'm going to stop you there. I was saying that this whole time, this is the Cardinals' biggest issue, and now it's starting to seem like, you know what? The game plan isn't that bad. And the coaching, maybe we're giving them too much of a hard time. The game plans they're coming up with are not bad. They're winning, obviously. And like I said, Packers should have knocked on wood. That's what happens when you get tested. Bad things happen.
Here we go.
Devontae's sick, man.
Devontae's out. He's Lazard out. is out.
Lazard.
Those are huge holes.
Randall Cobb.
Those are huge holes. Walker. But don't forget, we do have Cobb. We have Valdez-Scantling, and we do have St. Brown. Those are all good receivers.
Don't forget about Tonyan the Bunyan.
Hey, I was just going to get to my big boy right there. We can always open the playbook up and pass the ball not only to Tonyan but to Jones, to A.J. Dillon. Mm-hmm. I mean, we've got options. Now, granted, I'm not making any excuses.
You are making excuses.
It's a huge hole losing Davante Adams.
See, but that's the issue is not only are you going to have to make up for no pressure being there, and even though the Cardinals might be missing most of their offensive line, I still think Kyler's not going to take that many hits. I don't think there's going to be very much stopping the Cardinals' offense. Alexander's still out. There's just too much going on. Jalen Smith is probably going to be your designated spy, which is not the greatest thing in the world coming from a Cowboys fan. So I really think the Cardinals are going to do more running on the Packers than passing, but that's gonna open up the passing to kind of just cherry on top, not gonna allow the Packers to get within two scores. It's gonna start a little slow, but Packers are gonna lose by two possessions.
All right,
I
say Packers win by a game-winning field goal. Aaron Rodgers rushing. You got to remember, before that game.
Not only is he rushing in a touchdown, but they're also kicking the game-winning field goal. Mm-hmm. Well, they should have tried that in the playoffs last year, huh? Hey, it sounds like you're just reliving the past buddy.
I'm just saying. Mark my words. We're winning by a field goal. I didn't say rushing the end zone. I said he's gonna rush it down the field in a 2-minute drill. It's gonna happen. It's gonna go down.
No worry. I'm getting I'm 1 point closer now. Thank you. I appreciate it.
I got plenty of room. I'm okay. Blue collar workhorse of the week. Who do you got?
I got Jamar Chase.
Good choice.
The defense was chasing him all day.
Yeah, they were.
8 receptions, 200 yards. Oh, from afar.
From afar, they were chasing Jamar.
Yeah, they sure were. 8 receptions, 201 yards, and 1 touchdown. He ran up and down that field twice. It was more of like a check, you know? And that was where that one last yard came from. Who do you got for your workhorse?
I got Cooper Kupp. 10 receptions, 156 yards, and 2 tutties.
Two tutties, 1 cup.
I like that.
Yeah, no, you did.
He did great. I mean, he is one of the biggest reasons that Stafford has been successful.
Mm-hmm.
You know, facts.
Yeah.
FHC Insurance Liability of the Week. Go.
I got Justin Fields, my own rookie. He good went. Choice. Now, listen to this. This does not sound bad. 22 of 32.
Could be worse. Definitely. Definitely.
184 yards.
Three. Count them.
Interceptions. Ouch. 3 fumbles. Now. 2 were lost.
So 5 turnovers.
Yes. He could add 6, but he didn't. So could is he really the liability? That's debatable. At least he didn't get injured.
I gotcha. My FHC insurance liability of the week.
Who's calling Chris for you?
I have the entire Carolina Panther organization calling Chris.
Okay.
You need you need help, my boys. You need help. You need a policy that can cover that ass whooping that you received in New York. So here's my thing. Other than losing to the Giants, that's an issue.
That is an
issue. Other than losing to the Giants, the entire Panther offense had 200 total yards, and they didn't find the end zone.
Jamar had 1 more yard.
Right. And he found the end zone.
He did.
You know what I mean?
He did.
I don't understand it. They had not moved the ball at all, whether it be on the ground, in the air, over here, around there. It didn't matter.
Under there, under anywhere.
Right.
Yeah.
Your whole team, your whole organization is suspect, my boy. You don't deserve it.
You don't. You know, you're lucky we gave you the number to Chris. He's got his work cut out for him with these guys.
Right. Why don't we go ahead and move into baseball?
We sure will. And you want to know who will move right out of baseball? Walker Buehler.
That's right.
You know, Walker with a 7 ERA in the closeout game.
Hey, I'm okay with it. I called it that the Braves would beat the Dodgers.
You did.
4-2. Mm-hmm. Oh.
It's been a damn rough week for everybody on my side, which is everybody. It's been a rough one. But we coming back. We trade 1 week for the rest of the year.
Okay.
That's how that works.
All right. Well, I think you gave up your whole year for this week.
I might have.
I sure might. Braves beat the Dodgers. Rosario, three run home run to win it. The long one. Riley stays consistent. He had a ribby in that game.
Yeah.
My prediction was completely right. Dodgers go home. I am so happy.
Cody Bellinger had a ribby.
Yeah, right. So they came in. They came to Houston.
They sure did.
Let's see.
The final.
Let's do the, top of seven. Still going.
5-1 Braves. There was a leadoff home run. So all those that projected nobody scores in the first inning, you were wrong on the first batter.
No kidding.
That was the most popular bet this week.
Yep. And the Braves went back to work without hesitation.
Yep.
Give me your prediction for the World Series.
I got Braves winning it in 7.
Okay. I got Braves winning it in 5. 4-1. Now, mind you, only a few short months ago, I did say that the Braves would be in this position.
A few Altuves ago?
Yeah. I did say that the Braves would be in this position, and here they are. I say they're going to finish. They're going to pull it off. They're gonna win it in 5.
I hope they do. I don't want the Astros winning.
Other than that, no more news in baseball. Let's move on.
Not a lot of boringness.
Take me to Hockey Town.
Hockey. So, goal leaders. We're going to start off with that. Because I forgot to write the other ones down. Improv. So, goal leaders. We got Mr. Ovechkin. 7 goals leading it. Mr. Old Man himself. It's a good start for him, huh?
Leading the way.
And then tied for number 2.
This kid's going to be special.
He is. Tyler Bertuzzi. Yeah. Oh, I tricked it. No, it's the one that's going to be a little bit more specialer that we can all agree on is Connor McDavid.
Both with 6 goals.
Both with 6. Yeah. So is Kyle Connor and Kopitar.
Yeah. All Kopitar, a little old. He's still hanging in there.
Not as old as Alex, right. But, you know.
He's still hanging in there.
He is. And while we're on this, Detroit at number 3. I'm going to take a screenshot because that might be the last time we see this.
It's
And they were finally favored to win a game.
Yeah, first time in how
2
many?
Years?
Yeah, so it's been a while.
It has been
It's been rough in Hockey Town. I think since Yzerman is at the helm, we're going to be just fine. Mark my words,
the Yzer plan.
Mark my words. Within the next 2 or 3 years, we will have a Stanley Cup.
I don't think that's back in
Hockey Town.
Let's go 5. Eisenman's got a plan. He's got the Eisen plan.
He do.
I don't think in 2 years, but probably 4-5. I could get into that one.
On the other hand, the Blackhawks with the worst start in NHL history. The absolute worst.
How many times have they led?
6 games, they have led 0 times.
Oh.
That's never been done before.
Never.
Thank you, Chicago.
We've led the same amount in NHL.
You've been awful in all sports. Thank you. Basketball might be. But hockey, baseball, and football, you've been awful.
Awful.
And we appreciate you.
I don't appreciate your rookie quarterback, but we'll get into that. Tampa Bay off to kind of a sluggish start.
They are.
You know, I was thinking they might win it again this year, but, you know, slow start. Never, you know, it's real early. Oilers leading their division right now. 5-0.
Yeah.
Connor McDavid. Look at him. The Golden Knights, they're taking a real step back. They went from top to mid. Now they're at the bottom right now.
Yeah, they're not doing so hot.
Arizona, same story. What a sad story. Yeah. They got caught in a little cheating. Yeah. So they said, hey, draft picks. Nope.
No, thanks.
So that'll happen.
Yeah.
But
St. Louis.
Yeah.
5-0.
Oh, 5-0. Yeah, you are right. Minnesota, not far behind, a 4-1.
Carolina, 5-0.
Yeah.
5-0. Washington, not far behind them.
No. The Rangers? Goodness. 4-2.
Look out now. 4-2-1
4-2-1 Well, that's we can leave out that one. That's a loss.
Wait, that's a point. That's a point.
I know, but
you know what I mean?
You know, loss.
Florida, Florida. You know, here's the thing. Here's the thing about Florida. I feel like they're always a bridesmaid, never a bride.
And can Florida stop winning in things? Be like the Marlins, please.
I'm tired of it. Everybody, even the Seminoles have a better winning history than most of these hockey teams.
Yes. Florida winning too much is a bit of an issue.
Yeah.
Now, let's talk about Chicago a little bit. Let's switch it over, switch sports from the ice to the hardwood.
Okay.
The Bulls are 4-0. I didn't realize Michael Jordan is back on the court.
Taking care of business.
Mm-hmm, they sure are. And like I said before, New York is 3-1, not far behind. They're going to keep this up.
Look out for them.
I told you to take New York in the over-under against the 76ers. I just believed them. I believe them.
Hey, about New York. Something. Kyrie, is he on the move?
Oh, he is. And if I saw this trade rumor. If this is true, then Houston got the trade of the decade.
Okay.
Kyrie for John Wall.
Oof.
Are you kidding me?
Oof.
No, that's if you do that, thank you. Thank you. I'll take him and not play in Staples Center for us. We don't play in Staples Center.
Right, right.
You know, we don't play anywhere. We don't play over there. We play in H-Town.
Hey, speaking of that neck of the woods,
mm-hmm.
Warriors still 4-0. Perfect.
They're 4-0. They just won.
Yeah. Oh, there it is.
There it is. Let's see it right there. 106-98. Man, they're doing... It's going back,
look out,
huh?
Look out. Let's talk about some sluggish starts. Ooh. What three you got?
I got, and they're all three playoff teams. In the West,
uh-oh,
mind you.
Uh-oh.
The Lakers, the Clippers, and the Suns. Terrible starts right now. Now, the Lakers did just win in overtime against the Spurs.
We're talking about Melo killing it.
Who cares? Melo killing it. He did 75% from the three. He went 10 for 15 from the field goal and 100% from free throw. 28 points in 28 minutes. Have yourself a day, Melo.
Yeah, have a day. Have a day.
He did. And we will have ourselves a good week up until Thursday, where I'm going to redeem myself on the pick'ems. Guarantee it, Connie.
I'll tell you what. I'm going to enjoy my lead.
Go ahead.
You guys enjoy your week. The World Series will be on throughout the week. Enjoy that. Yes. Thursday Night Football will be a doozy. I will be barbecuing and drinking beer and watching it.
Nice.
Basketball, there's a few basketball games out there you need to go out and find. And as always, hockey's on throughout the week.
That's right.
Chock full of sports this week, folks.
It is. A lot of sports.
Make sure you go out and watch them.
Yep. No. NBA ended, so you won't be able to find that.
Right
now.
They,
highlights.
Chicago Sky did win.
Yep.
Congratulations, ladies.
Yep.
So, other than that, I think that's a show. We've talked some shit.
Talk some
Enjoy
shit.
Your week. You guys, take it easy.